Hello everyone, your radar contact and welcome to another VASAviation video. Welcome to the first video of a series that I wanted to bring back to the channel. Back in the day when I used to upload some videos explaining different things and topics about aviation, but I kind of stopped doing it because the audience was not very interested in it. But now the audience has grown very big, so I thought I might give it another try. So I purchased a whiteboard, purchased a new camera, and hopefully this will work out this time. Also hoping to be a little helpful for all those students that are preparing for their PPL or ATPL examination. So hopefully this will be helpful for them too. And as always, also thanks to my supporters on Patreon who made this possible. So yeah, that's it. Welcome, take a pencil, take your notes, and let's do it. So for this first video, I have chosen a meteorology topic, taking advantage of a video that I uploaded a few weeks ago about a Cessna Centurion that crashed in South Texas, and he was flying in very heavy and dangerous icing conditions. They encountered clear ice, freezing rain, so that is what we're going to talk about today: freezing rain, freezing drizzle, and clear ice. So first thing we have to know about freezing rain is when and where it forms. And normally, freezing rain is associated with warm fronts. And this is the profile of a warm front. We have a warm air mass, and remember, keep in mind that warm doesn't mean hot. This just means that this air mass right here is warmer than this cold air mass right here, okay? So, freezing rain is associated with warm fronts and inversions, temperature inversions. Keep that in mind. And where is that inversion? Normally, in the atmosphere, as you climb, the temperature decreases. So, in the temperature inversion, the opposite happens. As you climb, you can see it here in the warm front profile, as you climb, the temperature will increase as you go through the warm sector. This is called the warm sector. So the temperature will increase. So keep in mind, for all those students also preparing for their examinations, freezing rain is associated with warm fronts and temperature inversions. So imagine this situation right here, very common in the atmosphere. We have a layer of very cold air, very high up in the atmosphere, and then we have a warm front. And this cold air mass is going to cause some kind of precipitation, usually in the form of snow or hail. And this precipitation right here, this snow, will eventually drop and go through the warm sector. And this is warm, so that snow or that hail will melt into water. And now before we go down to the cold sector here, let me talk about just something about ice. In order for water to become ice, to freeze and form ice crystals, we need what is called a freezing nuclei. And the freezing nuclei can be just particles of dust, haze, or pollution. So, if the water is pure enough, that water can go through a layer of below freezing temperature and still be in the liquid state. And that is very interesting. So that water will not create ice crystals if that droplet of water doesn't find a freezing nuclei. And that is important, that it's a new term that we have to know, and it's SLD. For all those preparing for your examinations, keep this in mind. SLD, and that is supercooled large droplets. That means that the droplet of water, the water in the liquid state, the drop of water is still in the liquid state even below freezing temperature. So now we go down, this rain, this is just rain, this water, goes down through the cold sector, and this air mass right here is very cold, it can be below freezing. But this water, first, is pure enough to now find a freezing nuclei and form ice by its own, and doesn't have enough time, it's not for a long time in the cold sector, to become ice and form ice crystal by its own. So these droplets are in the liquid state and below 0 degrees Celsius, below freezing temperature. So now we can imagine and we can deduce that in this part right here, in the warm sector, keep in mind, we can find freezing rain and freezing drizzle. And the difference between those two, it's just the size, the diameter of the droplet. Okay, so now we know where we can find freezing rain, and it is in a warm sector and temperature inversions. Now, the dangerous thing about freezing rain is the ice it forms, and it is clear ice, also called glaze ice or rain ice. And we're gonna talk about this in a second. So freezing rain and freezing drizzle, the only difference is the size of the droplet, forms clear ice, glaze ice, or rain, and rain ice. These three are the same, just called differently. So as we said earlier, in order for water to become ice, it needs to find a freezing nuclei, but there's another way of forming ice crystals, and that is by pressure. So heating the ice surface will cause the molecules inside the droplet to align and form ice crystals and freeze instantly or almost instantly. And that is important here. And remember, this L right here, this is large, okay? Remember, because there's a difference between rime ice and clear ice. We'll not go very deep in that today, but there's a difference between rime ice for small droplets and clear ice for large droplets. Well, take a look at this. Imagine this is a droplet of water, very big, very large. And at some point as we advance, as we move with our aircraft, this water of droplet, super cool. Remember, this droplet here is in the liquid state. But this droplet here can be below 0 degrees Celsius, so it's super cool, right? It's not ice, it's still water, it's still liquid, but below 0 degrees Celsius. And at some point, this water, this droplet, will heat our wing. And our wing will probably be below 0 degrees Celsius as well, as we are flying in a layer below freezing. So as soon as this droplet here hits our wing surface, it will tend to freeze, but also, since it is very large, it will also try to flow back. So this droplet will slowly flow back and down the wing, and as it moves back, it will form ice. This is very exaggerated, but you can make a picture of this. The droplet will hit the wing and will be forming ice as it moves back and down the wing. So this is the hazard that clear ice causes in aviation. Because rime ice is different. Again, I will not go very deep in rime ice today, but rime ice is a small droplet that instantly hits hits the wing and instantly forms ice. So rime ice, let's take another color, just purple. Rime ice will form ice here on the leading edge of the wing. And here we can defend ourselves against ice, because most airplanes, general aviation airplanes, have an ice protection system here, and I'm sure you have heard about this already. And this is the ice boots. Are we recording? Yes, we are. And this is the ice boots, and the ice boots is a system, a DI system, so it's a system that we activate once the ice has already formed. And this is a pneumatic system. These boots right here inflate with air and break the ice off the wing. But only these boots are only equipped and installed on the leading edge of the wing. But now we have clear ice somewhere not protected against ice, so that is dangerous. If we have rime ice, and we can clearly see rime ice because it's opaque, so we can see we are building up rime ice on the leading edge of the wing, we activate the de-ice boots, and we eliminate that rime ice. But we still have clear ice on top of the wing, and we cannot get rid of that ice, at least not very easily. So the dangers of clear ice, glaze ice, and rain ice is, first, it forms somewhere that we cannot get rid of it. Second, it is very heavy, so it adds up weight to our aircraft, more weight, different performance and everything, stall speed, and well, all kind of performance degradation. Third, it will change and modify and alter the shape of our wings. So now the wind, the relative wind, will not flow steady down the wing, but it will become, oh, there's a wall of ice right here, so it will become turbulent. More turbulent, degradation of performance, stalling speeds, and everything. And fourth, and very important too, this clear ice is clear, so it is transparent. So from the cockpit, it is not very clear that you are building clear ice. It's not very visible. So you have to be very careful because you don't know that you're building clear ice. So those are the dangers of clear ice. So here's a video that I found on the internet. Some guys trying to get rid of that clear ice, and you can see they're having a hard time doing it because clear ice sticks very well to the surface, it's heavy, and it's very difficult to break it off the airplane. So that's it for today about freezing rain and clear ice. Hopefully this will work out this time. I'm very excited, also trying to be helpful for those students that are preparing for their examinations. So if I have missed something or you have any suggestions, let me know in the comments. Also let me know in the comments what other topics you want me to talk about next. And if you're a student, also let me know in the comments how can I help you. So that's it for today. Squawk VFR, frequency change approved, and see you in the next one.